All right, welcome to Dumbbell Strength. My name is Ken Hearn. I'm going to be taking you through that Dumbbell Strength class today. We're going to work on some isolation work. So we're going to work on some biceps, some triceps, some chest, and we're going to put a little bit of legs in there. So we'll drift through those. We're going to work in each section there today. So you'll need some dumbbells, hence the Dumbbell Strength class. If you don't have any dumbbells, you can always grab some water bottles with weight. You can always grab like laundry jugs, things like that. Something that has some weight that you can move with as far as dumbbells or weighted objects go. From there, first thing we got to do, get our warm up on. Make sure we get the credit on the watch, right? Hands come up. For our warm up, we're just going to reach to the toes, sit in, and reach right up. Reach down, sit in. Number two. Excellent. Three. Four. Five. Six. Seven. Three more here. Eight. Nine. One more. And number 10, let's go ahead and get those hamstrings warmed up a little bit more. We're just going to kick them back here. Just going to do five of these. This is number three. Four, our inverted hamstrings. Number five, excellent. Let's switch the side. Three, two, one. Just five on the back side. Two, two. Three, four. And number five, shake it out there. Just a little bit of an arm circle here. Get those shoulders and arms moving. Return it back. Three, two, one. Bring those arms in here. And all I want you to do is extend out. Extend out. We're gonna do six, six, five, four, three, two, one. Give me the other side. One, two, three, four, five, six. Just getting those all nice and loose because we're gonna start right with our biceps. So we'll get those biceps going. So what we've got is we've got a bicep curl. Make sure I got it right. Okay, so we got a standard palms facing bicep curl. Then we're gonna turn it into a hammer curl. Now the difference between the bicep curl is gonna start from here and go all the way down. Hammer curl is going to start slightly in a slight bend, right? So we're going to keep it right here and go. And then the last thing that we're going to do is we call bent over curl. We'll get lighter weight, hands will come out here, and we'll pull it right to us. If you have any bands, you could also do a banded curl. All right, but we're all dumbbells today, right? So we're going to go with that. All right, so for your curls, pick something that you're comfortable with. You can always switch weights if you need to. Our goal here is three sets of 10. So work the best you can. We've got normal curls up first. Tighten that core, squeeze the glutes. Back flat, three, two, one, here we go. One, two, nice and easy on these. Three, these come all the way to the side. Four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10. Now let's turn them, right? We're gonna come to the slight bend here. One, stay at that slight bend. Two, three, four, five, six. Oh, they burn now, right? Seven, great job. Eight, nine, and 10. Let's go ahead and put those down. Smaller dumbbell here. Not gonna need as much weight. Get that back flat. Reach the arms out. Pull it right to the ears. One, keep those elbows high. Two, three, four. If you've got the right weight, five, you won't put pressure on the back. Six, you'll just feel a little bit in those biceps. Seven, eight, nine, 10. This would be kind of close to doing a preacher curl, so if you're leaning over a bench. All right, shake them out. Set number two coming up. Let's go ahead and grab the heavier dumbbells. This is your chance to adjust the dumbbells if needed. If not, come right here. Standard curls, 3, 2, 1, go. We're burning muscle groups out one at a time today. Here's 10. Excellent job. Shake them if you need to. Get ready for that hammer curl. 3, 2, 1. Up. Slight bend. 1. Nine. Last one. Biceps. Find that good weight. Another thing, if you didn't like that position, you can go into a kneeling reach curl, right? So now I'm just keeping my elbows up. You can go to the same one we did before. Last one. 10, excellent job. Now here's where we make the difference, right? Our third set, third and final set. You can keep that weight, stay with that weight. If you only have one certain set of weight, you can't get to 10, then give me 8. Give me what you've got. Third set here. Regular curls. 3, 2, 1. Here we go. 1, 2. Don't have to speed them up. 3. 4, sometimes we go faster because it hurts. 5, we want to go slower when that happens. 6, we want the muscles to work. 7, don't let them work on momentum. 8, 9, 10, you control your muscles. You make them do the work, right? Sometimes, when we're not so tight. All right, slight bend, here we go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, slight bend, 6, 7, almost the dumbbells touching the back of the front of the thigh, 8, that's how far we're going, 9, last one, 10, excellent job on those, definitely felt those. Up next, again, bent over or kneeling, up to you. I like the kneeling version for me personally, but again, doesn't matter. We just want to make sure arms are up. Here we go. Curls. 1, 2. Go right next to the ears. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Again, the weight's got to be light enough. 8, that I can hold my arms up. 9, 10. We're getting a little shoulder in there, right? It's not a bad thing. It happens to the best of us. All right, we got legs up next. We got a combo set, 3 exercises. We're going to do our standard goblet squat. So holding a dumbbell here, nice and low goblet squat. Then we're going to go down to the ground. We're going to do hip bridges. Then we're going to flip it over and do what we call fire hydrant. So just all fours. Those two won't need a dumbbell, but you'll still be working them. So heavy dumbbell. I like going pretty heavy for the goblet squat. You don't have to go super heavy, but when we're holding it, this is at the chest, right? We don't want it way out here because it'll pull us over. So keep it at the chest. Little wider than shoulder width. Goal is elbows come down to the knees, but that doesn't have to happen. If you got to do this to do it, that's not a good thing. We got to be tall, right? We got to be able to stay tall. Elbows go down that way. Are you guys ready? Here we go. We got 10 goblet squats. 3, 2, 1, let's go. 1, I'm gonna open up those hip flexors now. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. Excellent job. All right, so we got our glute bridges. If you want to add weight here, you're more than welcome to keep those weights. Keep that one dumbbell, the heavy dumbbell if you want, put it right in the hips. And then when you go up, You're holding on so it doesn't roll towards you. Here we go. 3, 2, or just do a regular glute bridge. 3, 2, 1. Here we go. 1. Push those heels into the floor. 2. Tuck that belly spine. 3. Toes can come up if you want a little extra. 4. 5. 6. 7. 8. 9. Last one here. And 10. Just let that roll off if you used it at all. All right, we're going to try to keep pressure on the glute medius here. So it's leg here and then down. 10 and then switch. 3, 2, 1. Here we go. 1, 2, 3. The big thing is you don't want to, 4. You don't want to twist. You just want to open. 5, 6, 7, 8. We're going right into the next one. 9, 10. Here we go. 1, 2. Try to keep the hips straight. 3. Open it up using those glutes. 4, 5, 6. You'll feel it come through here. 7, 8, 9, 10. Excellent job. Shake those legs out a little bit as we come up, and we're right back to our goblet squat. Are you ready? 3, 2, 1. Of course you're ready, right? Here we go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Last one. 10. All right. We're flipping it over now. Glute bridges. Get right through these today. 3, 2, 1. Here we go. 1, 2, 3, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. And there's our number 10. Let's go ahead and roll that dumbbell off right into those fire hydrants. Flat back in the center of the knee. 1. Here we go. 2, 3. Keep your hips forward. Keep your eyes down. 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Excellent. Let's switch it up. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. Good. All right. Well, done with that second set, the leg set, folks. We're going to move on to the chest next. I know you're ready for that, right? All right, but before we get there, let's get our last set of goblet squats in. Nice and tall, eyes forward. Here we go. 1. See those smiles. 2, 3. Excellent job. 4. Stay tall. 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Excellent work. Let's come back down. Glute bridges. Coming up next. All right, 3, 2, 1. Let's go. 1, 2, 3. Belly to spine here. 3 left. Last one. Excellent job. Great job, folks. Great job. All right. Shoulders under the hands. Hands under the shoulders. Let's flip that switch. All right. Here we go. Open it up. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Let's flip it over. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and number 10. Hopefully you felt that coming through the back of the glute there. Excellent, excellent job, everyone. All right, next up is going to be our chest set. Very simple chest set. We've got chest presses with the dumbbells. Then we're going to flip it over. Another non-dumbbell exercise, but very potential good exercise, is the push-up, right? Always good to do push-ups. Push-up can be done off the wall, off an elevated surface, off your knees from the ground, or off your toes from the ground. And then we flip it over right after that for a fly. So pick out your weights. You got a chest fly and you got a chest press. So I want you guys to pick wisely on both. What's good for the fly, what's good for the press. All right. So remember, when we're doing our presses, our chest presses especially, we want to come down first. If we're on a bench, no change happens on a bench. We pull our dumbbells to us, get in that nice position. Dumbbells on the thighs, we're going to use gravity to bring them up, right? We're going to come up as they come to the chest, turn our arms, and then press up from there. All right, here we go. 10 presses. 3, 2, 1. Let's get it. 1, 2, 3. Nice quick chest set. 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Bring them right down. Flip the body over. Push up. However you feel comfortable doing a push up. Toes, knees, wall. Up to you. Give me 10. Two more now. Excellent job on those push-ups. Flip it back over. Find your good flies. Same thing here. Bring them up to the knees. This time, when we come up, we bring them right up over chest, not overhead. All right, you shouldn't be looking straight up at them. If you're over here, that's too far up. They want to be over our chest from here. We swing down, slight bend in the elbow. Back up. The other way you can do it, if you're worried about the shoulders, you can have the dumbbells butt each other. This just protects the shoulders a little bit more. Here we go. 3, 2, 1. Let's go. Slight bend in the elbow. Down we go. 1. Keep that slight bend. 2. Almost like you're trying to do a Hulk Hogan pose, right? 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 8, 9, and 10. Excellent. The beauty of isolating muscles is to make them work, to not give them that rest, to overload them so that we get into a good fatigue cycle. Rest, good nutrition, 24 hours. Muscles build stronger fibers, sometimes even increasing the fibers. All right, here we go. Chest presses. 3, 2, 1. Let's bring it back. Good. 3, 2, 1. Good breathing. Stay over the chest. All right, it's our flip over time. Let those down nice and easy. Always trying to avoid the other ones. Your turn to do 10 push-ups again. Best way you can do them. 3, 2, 1. Give me those good 10. Halfway there. Last one. unless you're a little bit quicker of a push-up expert than me. Now, remember when doing push-ups. A lot of people do them really, really fast. It's good to still have a 2-2 tempo. 1,000-1,002, 1,000-1,002. Muscles work better if they're working nice and slow and concentrated than if we're... That's all just... We work a lot on just the momentum there instead of the actual strength. All right, we got our flies. Almost forgot the flies. Flies, come back. 3, 2, 1. Slight bend of the elbows. Let's go. Stay over your chest, folks. Last one here, good flies. Excellent job, let's go ahead and put those down. Come on back up, quick little shake out. Your last set of chest presses. Adjust dumbbells as you need to. If you only have one heavy one, you can't do both heavy ones. Then pick it up like this to your chest press with two hands on one dumbbell. Always an option to modify. 3, 2, 1, let's go. Press them out. And number 10, very good. Go ahead and put those over. Your last set of push-ups, folks. When doing these push-ups, try to keep the body flat. Try to keep everything straight. Where I'm going. There we go. 3, 2, 1, and let's go. Nice and concentrated. I got one more. About the time you start feeling those arms, the chest really kick in. Those reps, when we're tired, are the best ones. Here we go, up for flies. Slight bend in the elbows, here we go. Stay over your chest. And 10. Excellent, excellent work, folks. All right. So our last flat set, we're gonna squeeze in tricep and back together. First exercise, we're gonna be on all fours. We're gonna row, kick back, 10 on the right arm, 10 on the left arm. All right, then the next one, we're gonna come up, sort of like our bicep. This position right here, row, kick back. Row. So we got two rows with a kickback, just two different positions. All right. And then our last one, we're going to have a slight lean forward, pull here, up and down. All right. Upright rows there. This will be more upper back. We're still going to get that back. All right. So first one, up and kick back. Let's find it. 3, 2, 1. Here we go. So row, one. Last one here. Let's go ahead and roll it over. Other side, 3, 2, 1. Row, kick it back, 1. Thank you. Two more. Excellent, excellent job. May want to go a little lighter on this next one. Bent over row with a kickback. Talk about your doubling down on a muscle group, right? Same exercise, just standing. Arms are out forward. Let's go ahead, row in, kick back, one. Perfect. Pull in, two. Pull those shoulder blades, three. Kick that butt back, four. Flat back. And number 10, swing them. You may need to go down a little bit on this one. If not, slight bend in the knees. Here we go, one. Elbows high. Last one, 10, excellent job. No rest for the weary, folks. Row kickback, style one, up next. Adjust the weights as you need to. Arms are gonna get tired. Here we go. Excellent job. Let's switch it up. Three, two, one. Excellent work. All right, so we're gonna stand up. Same thing, just with a bent over. A little butt kick out. Find the right weights. The last time was a little heavy. Go ahead and downsize those weights just a little bit. If not, stick the butt out. Arms out, here we go. One. Control it with your arms. Two. Three, tighten your abdominals. Four. Five, six, seven, eight, nine, and number 10. Shake them out. Upright row. Remember with the upright row, lead. We're not trying to roll the wrist. They'll roll a little bit, but lead with your elbow. Three, two, one, let's go. Dumbbells come to chest height. And number 10. All right. Last roll through. Find the right weight for you. Come on back down. Let's burn those back muscles. And those tricep muscles up. Here we go. Three, two, one, pull. One, two, three, there we go, let's switch it up. Three, two, one. Bro, kick it back. Last one. Number 10 on that one. All right. Get your lighter dumbbells if needed. Find a good dumbbell weight. Push that butt out. Control it with your glutes, your core, and those strong arms of yours. 3, 2, 1. Here we go. Little lean. 2, 3. Excellent job. 4, 5. You'll notice I got a wide stance. 6. That helps me keep stay balanced. 8, 9, and number 10. Shake them out, folks. This is it. 3, 2, 1. Give me your best upright rows. Here we go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and number 10. Great, great job. Great, great finish. Excellent job to all of you. Biceps, triceps, chest, back, and a little bit of legs today. You did great. Thank you so much for joining me for Dumbbell Strength. Always remember, stretch major muscle groups. We have quick stretches on our YouTube page. You can check those out anytime. Make sure you cool down, make sure you stretch. Make sure you come back next time. Thanks, everyone.